But you have to understand him. You have to understand David. You have to understand Moses. You cannot just split them and use one part of their life, but you have to put them together and recognize them and see them. That's why with Jesus you cannot do the same. You cannot only use one verse before he died, when he died, and after he died, and to use them as, and they're totally the same. They're not totally the same. Here he addresses disciples. Here he addresses Jewish people. Here he addresses the church. Here speaking about the Holy Spirit. So you have to understand, you have to get the bigger picture. Because if you divide it, you will make a mess out of the preachings and you will torture the people in your church and nobody can become what you're asking. So fear is the, I would say, fear hinders people to be courageous and hinders people to be bold. And if you cannot grow in the love of God, you will push yourself to be strong and courageous, but it just doesn't work. So my message to this morning, I don't know if it scares you, I have many scary stories to tell you, but if it scares you or if it's not, grow in the love of God. That will make you very strong. You know, you think that love is weak. No, love is very strong. Love is the strongest thing ever that you can meet on this earth. Because love, it's, you cannot compare it to nothing. This world does not understand love. This world just cannot connect to the love of God. It's just too foreign for it. And it says like, we don't understand. How can you love enemies? Oh, I said that, we don't understand you. How can you give your life? How can you do it? They don't understand love. They can understand our meetings. They can understand what we do technically. But love is not understood by the world. You have to understand that. And that's why the world does not recognize you as a normal person, as a sober person. They say, they're crazy. They don't understand you because they don't understand the love of God. Let me tell you one more story. This is more a dream. And I was in Strumica. So it was like a dream, a real dream. And I was captured. I was captured by an army. And now they're taking me to these dungeons, you know, like prisons. And they take me there and they said, you are going to meet him now. And I was like, whom that I'm going to meet? They said, you're going to meet the chief of all the demons. He says, you're going to meet Satan. And I was kind of like, you know, I wonder how will I react on that. Now, I was locked in a like kind of a cell or some kind of dungeon. And they said, you're going to meet him. And what I did, I wasn't afraid so much. I was afraid, but not so much. And it's just like he came, or this person, which is called Satan, came. And I just looked at him and said, is he like that? Does he look like that? He's not so terrifying as they say that he's terrifying, you know. And so, and then I just kind of ran away from the prison, I have to admit. But, and then I started to burn the whole thing. But I just was interesting. I was amazed by my reaction. I was thinking like, so he's not so scary as they say that he's scary. That was my reaction. So I was like, it's okay. I can deal with this. But you understand, but if you were born with this idea like, the devil, be careful, pray for me, put crosses on the walls, you know, put garlic, like, you know, the vampires thing, you know, so you will be afraid. But if you live in the love of God, you know, you don't need that. You know, people say, where are the cross in this church? I said, we don't need those crosses, you know, where are the... So, if you understand that you're loved, you will be strong. You will be courageous. You will be active. You will act in faith. You will speak in faith. Now, many times when you will speak in faith, people say you're arrogant. How can you say something like this? But you can. If you learn that you're loved by God, you can. You know, I say to people, I can go to sleep anywhere and I know nothing will happen to me. That sentence is arrogance to many. Many who say, how can you dare to say that nothing will happen to you? Nothing will happen to me unless the Holy Spirit tells me that something will come and happen to me. The Paul was like that. Paul says, the Holy Spirit says to your prophet, he says, if you go to that place, you will be locked, you will be bound. He told him.